My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. For he has looked with mercy on my lowliness. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me. Holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceitful ways. He has cast the mighty from their thrones and lifted up the lowly to himself. He feeds the hungry with good things. The rich are sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel. For he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers from of old, to Abraham and his children forever. Amen to our God who's faithful to his own.
Free and hail him as your heavenly King. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion in the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
Christ is risen. Alleluia.
He is truly risen. Alleluia.
And ascended into heaven to sit at the Father's right hand as the head of his body, the church, of which you are a member. I am one in Christ. And by God's mercy, by God's grace, in and through this difficult age, there's always a difficult age, this is the current one, permitted to regather at the altar of sacrifice, protocols in place and all, because we are in phase four. Eternity, the ascension of our Lord. Let's call to mind our sins and enter into the saving, sacred sacrifice of Mass.
Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us glorify God with the angels, with the saints. His body, the church, glorifies him. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you,
we adore you,
we glorify you.
We give you thanks for your great glory.
Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son,
Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
You take away the sin of the world.
Receive our prayer.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Holy One.
You alone are the Lord.
You alone are the Most High,
Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit,
in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, whose Son today ascended to the heavens as the apostles looked on, grant, we pray, that in accordance with his promise, we may be worthy for him to live with us always on earth. And we with him in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen, he presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, It is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. All you peoples, clap your hands, shout to God with cries of gladness. For the Lord, the Most High, the Awesome, is the great King over all the earth. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. God mounts his throne amid shouts of joy, the Lord amid trumpet blast. Sing praise to God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. For King of all the earth is God, sing hymns of praise. God reigns over the nations. God sits upon his holy throne. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, What are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones? And what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe? In accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead, and seating him at his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet and gave him as head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. In your heart, on your lips, you will proclaim this holy gospel worthily in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Says the Lord, I am with you always until the end of the world.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they saw him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always, until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Christ is risen. Alleluia.
He is truly risen. Alleluia.
Christ has ascended. Alleluia. He is truly ascended. Alleluia. This brings us into phase four. We opened Holy Mass, and I'm not talking about the phase one and phase two and phase three of our medical officials and experts and government leaders and all this. I understand that. I'm talking about the big phase four. It's marked with Jesus's ascension into heaven. It's marked with, "I am with you always." Phase four is marked with Jesus seated at the right hand of God the Father. You know who sits at the right hand in earthly dynasties, right? It's like the prime minister. Jesus is now in charge, as it were. He is the head, we, the body, members, and the head informs the body. The head gives the body life. This is phase four. He is with us always, and thanks be to God for the ascension. It's not an abandoning. It is the mature the mature fulfillment of salvation history. Phase four. I'm aware of the three phases, you know, that we have to honor, and there's dignity in doing that, you know, respecting the masks and the social distancing, and you know, then, you know, we can meet right now in certain numbers and certain configurations, and I mean, it seems like Walmart and Home Depots and all these, you know, have been quite, you know, crowded and all throughout, to be honest with you. But I'm okay with phase one, this physical thing. I'm okay with physical phase two, right? Physical phase two, I think then we can something like, and again, I'm not an official, but I believe phase two, you know, will relax some of the protocols and we'll be able to have some seating indoors instead of just dining, you know, on outdoor patios of restaurants and on streets and stuff like that. And then there'll be phase three, and these three physical phases, these three medical phases, government phases, as it were, and yes, we have to honor them, okay? But they're earthbound. And I'm okay, right? Because right now, we are living our eternal souls in these earthly bodies. But let's not pretend. Let's not forget. Let's not even entertain what many have forgotten and what many do entertain. Man, we have to do all we can because this world is all we got. That's not true. Materialism says it's true. Secularism says it's true. The pagan and atheistic culture says it's true. But your deepest self, who are alive in phase four. So what are the first three phases of this salvation history then? If the ascension marks the beginning of phase four, I am with you always. I am seated at the Father's right hand. And by the way, this phase four, this ascension, brothers and sisters, we are not talking about a literal elevator, okay, where Jesus gets in and like pushes like the H button for heaven. You know what I mean? We're not talking about a physical, literal, wow, what planet must he be on now? We are talking about a higher realm, a higher existence, the full reality of God. And Jesus has been enjoying this for him, as it were, right, in the Easter season. The risen, glorious Lord. All right, let's talk about what are the first three phases, we can call them phases, that lead to this phase four. First phase is this, from Adam to Jesus. Phase one, spiritually speaking, is God loving us into being, breathing an eternal soul into us. God anguishing at the stupidity of humanity and the ego of humanity to grasp at godliness and suffer original sin and suffer the, you know, a beautiful garden turning into a dry, dead desert. And Cain and Abel, one slaying the other. And Noah and betrayal and shame and an entire nation held captive Israel, held captive in Egypt. And then by God's merciful hand, leading them out only to wander because they just want to be their own God. They just want to call the shots. Yes, from Adam to Jesus is phase one. It's God lovingly wanting to communicate everything to us, but we don't have the onboard equipment. We have forsaken that. And so phase two, the Word becomes flesh and dwells among us. This is the phase of Jesus' earthly life. And for you and me particularly, I mean, we know the 3 years of Jesus' public ministry. Yes, we have the birth narratives in Matthew and Luke. And it's talking about, you know, the cave, the stable, and the animals, and Christmas Eve and Christmas morning. And yes, I understand the nativity narratives. But you and me know Jesus primarily through his 3 years in public ministry. This is when God and man, phase two, the Word in human flesh, heals, forgives, feeds, teaches, nourishes, enlightens, okay? He enlightens us, but we're kind of in our still right human tent, as it were, our human bodies. Our souls can become enlightened, right? But we're not glorious. Here's phase three. We killed him. And he rose from the dead. And for these 40 days, we will call Easter season phase three. For 40 days, glorified, risen from the dead. Now, here's the two realms. Here's the heavenly realm to which he ascended and the earthly realm in which we still live, completely married as one. In these 40 days, he's walking through walls, walking through locked doors, still has his wounds in his hands, feet inside. He's roasting fish on the shore saying, cast your net over the other side and you will catch something. He's enlightening them. He, completely glorified, is, as it were, a prefigurement of phase four, showing himself to you and me. Now, phase four opens up. He ascends into heaven, and you and I are enlightened. He pours forth the Holy Spirit. Jesus, like the master conductor of a symphony to God's glory, leading you and me in our lives. I mean, our earthly rational brains are fine things, folks, but trust me, they're not going to save you or me or anybody. And our rational thinking hits the ceiling and bounces down. Even scientists, the most brilliant scientists, have a firm grasp on 1/1000th of 1% of all the information that exists. I think I'd rather open up to phase four and know that he is with me, with you always until the end of the age. And so, yes, we worship, right? They worshiped, but they doubted. Yes, we worship. Phase four people worship. It solidifies, reaffirms, clarifies that we, even though we are in this world, are alive in Jesus Christ. We live in phase four. And we hear in the second reading today, you know, and he will give the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit will fill you with a sense of knowledge and wisdom so that you see with phase four eyes. You understand, your brain goes through the roof with phase four wisdom. You love with phase four love. It's God's own heart beating in you and me. And I am a sinner, and you are a sinner, yes, because we are not yet glorified. But we are in phase four. And the first reading beautifully puts, and when he had ascended, you know, and left their physical sight, the gospel fire filled them, and they evangelized. They evangelized. I'm well aware of the COVID cost. It's hit my, the physical virus has hit my family 5 times already up north. 5 times. My cousin is already, she's 86, but has died from COVID. This is all up north, you know, in New England and in New Jersey. I'm well aware of the physical ravages. But brothers and sisters, far more than physical ravages of any physical virus is denying the eternal salvation of what Christ has done, who he is, and who he has made us to be. So yes, we continue to live, we wear our masks, we use the alcohol, you know, pour it all over us, we, you know, we take the varnish off the pews with the alcohol now. That's, I'm gonna have to re-varnish them. You know, all of these protocols, yes, by all means. We do what's responsible while in these earthly tents, but these earthly tents are not it. So please, as we celebrate the ascension of our Lord, Jesus seated at the right hand of the Father, you and me alive in the Lord, who is with us always until the end of the age. We are mindful of the wisdom and the knowledge of God that goes much higher than any rational knowledge. I mean, we're pretty rational, right? We're pretty rational. We can use propositions, complete sentences and everything. But the wisdom of God, deeper, wider, remarkable. As we unfold and begin opening up in faith, now we're back to physical phase 1, 2, and 3. Beautifully, we will begin to worship at daily mass again. We will have daily mass Monday morning, 10 a.m. And it will be videoed. It'll be open to parishioners with social distancing and all that. It will be videoed and made available by noontime to parishioners. So each day, daily mass should be available to parishioners by noontime. And, you know, we'll do this for some weeks more. It's very, very costly to do it. With the quality that we're working with, but perhaps you could assist with that. Also, we will begin praise and worship again, Adoration of the Blessed Sacrament, this Wednesday, 7 o'clock. Appropriate social distancing and all? Sure. This coming Sunday is the Feast of Pentecost, the outpouring of the Holy Spirit that gives you and me the brains and heart of God, even while we are in this fleshy fallen world, right? And on this Feast of Pentecost, oh my goodness gracious, beautiful things. First Holy Communions for our children who have accepted it at this point. If not, we'll delay it for the rest. Sunday morning on Pentecost, also baptisms and confirmations and Holy Communions of those in RCIA. And confirmations, the Holy Spirit coming upon our teenagers who have been waiting for this gift and fire. Look, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. We live in phase 4. Christ is ascended. Alleluia. He is truly ascended. Alleluia. I believe in one God,
the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us lift our petitions to Jesus seated at the right hand of the Father, the head of whom we are his body. We lift our needs. While we live in phase 4, we still are in this earthly life for the time being. And so we lift our needs for our earthly needs and our eternal salvation needs to the Lord. Let our response be, Lord Jesus, risen and ascended, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, risen and ascended, hear our prayer.
For all bishops, priests, and deacons, may they be effective witnesses of the Lord risen and ascended. We pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, risen and ascended, hear our prayer.
For world leaders who follow the example of Christ, may God help them in their service to their people and the kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, risen and ascended, hear our prayer.
For all who are seeking employment, May God open new opportunities for them to share their gifts and talents. We pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, risen and ascended, hear our prayer.
For those who are in need of hope and be inspired by the ascension of our Lord and trust firmly that God offers them eternal happiness and the means to obtain it, we pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, risen and ascended, hear our prayer.
For our faith community, rejoicing as an Easter people, may God bless our efforts to protect the dignity and sanctity of human life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, risen and ascended, hear our prayer.
For the special intention of this Mass, for special birthday blessings for James Hall, and for the people of St. Joan of Arc, we pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, risen and ascended, hear our prayer. Pray with me, brothers and sisters, for a God-given and God-driven remedy to this physical virus, a physical remedy to a physical virus that does not compromise human dignity by using stem cells from aborted babies. We pray for clarity, spiritual clarity, in a deeper vaccine, a spiritual vaccine, freeing us from sin, helping us to see the dignity of all human beings and serving as Christ in and through one another. We pray to the Lord. Lord Jesus, risen and ascended, hear our prayer.
Bless us, Heavenly Father, who come to you in and through your Son, our Lord, as we seek the help of his mother and pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, fruit of the earth, work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray now, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Amen.
O God, whose only begotten Son, our High Priest, is seated ever living at your right hand to intercede for us, grant that we may approach with confidence the throne of grace and there obtain your mercy through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just. Our duty, our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus Christ, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens. As the angels gazed in wonder, mediator between God and man, judge of the world, and Lord of hosts, Jesus ascended, not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he has first gone as our head and founder. now with angels, archangels, and thrones and dominions, with the heavenly hosts who adore and praise you, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, hosanna in the
indeed holy, O Lord, font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. Giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice once more, giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and to drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, and spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Barry, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, especially James, for whom we celebrate this Eucharist, that with Blessed Mary, ever Virgin Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, and all who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through Christ, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At our Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that with the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
now and forever.
Lord Jesus, who said to his apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church," graciously grant her the peace and unity in accordance with your will, who reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Amen.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ keep you and me ever safe for eternal life.
Amen.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there.
Amen.
And unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Alleluia, quiaque meruis portare. Alleluia, resurrexit, sicut dixit. Alleluia. Ora pro nobis Deum. Alleluia.
Let us pray. May the gifts we have received from your altar, Lord, kindle in our hearts a longing for heavenly homeland, and cause us to press forward, following in the Savior's footsteps, to the place for our sake where he entered before us. who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, it'll be absolutely wonderful being in the same church at the same altar of sacrifice as we carefully enter into phase one, physical phase one here this weekend. Remember, we live in phase four eternally. The ascension has secured that for you and me. We are risen and alive in Christ. And yes, we worship and sometimes doubt, but the worship is the vital thing. For those of you so faithful, so beautifully alive in the domestic church, until you can be physically present again, know that you are absolutely in our hearts and thoughts and prayers. Know that at the offertory of this Mass, your desire to place your soul on this altar of sacrifice, and my desire and their desire, and those physically present and those not physically present, no distance blocks your sacrifice of your soul on the altar of sacrifice. It's Jesus offering himself to the Father, and you are Jesus. We're in phase four here, right? You and me are the body of Christ. We are Jesus. Jesus offers himself to the Father at Mass. And in terms of your physical offering, of your sacrificial giving, thanks be to God, we have been able to maintain staff and working very, very hard. And I just encourage you that if you are being fed, please continue to support your parish family and the outreach ministry you do and the ministry that grows here. It's very important that we not only stay afloat, but that we preach the gospel to the ends of the earth, right? In the Acts of the Apostles today. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Forget his promise. I am. choice to make, to make a break from earthly designs. And God's made of gold, the lower fires can never quench the raging desires. With caverns so deep, heart and the space to stand up with your embrace. I want the higher fire burning in me, burning in me. I have divine desire. Life, the hand of God reaching out to mine, eager to impart life sweetly mine, when lived as one with you, singing the song, a mystical one.